Now, we shall go for a transition. Okay, frequency of rotation spectral lines. Consider one transition from rotation level J to J, that is J hash to that of higher quantum number J. So, when this transition is taking place, we can calculate the energy difference between those two levels. Rotation energy level J dash, what is the energy? We know that is for whatever it is, V into J plus 1 is the energy equation. So, if at all your J dash is your rotation energy level, then you can give that h square by 8 pi square I into J hash into J hash plus 1. Okay. And E, that is higher quantum number J, it can also be given by the energy term h square by 8 pi square I into J plus 1. When you want to find the energy difference, you have to find higher quantum number J minus lower quantum number. That is the energy difference. So, when you can easily take it here, it is substituted h square by 8 pi square I. That is B complete, B rotational constant value is given. Just you can calculate with the B into J into J plus 1 minus B into J dash plus 1. Like that also you can calculate. Okay, when you calculate, here what you get is that frequency. The frequency, what is the frequency of the spectral lines? Okay, in terms of wave number, we are subtracting. So, what we can get is, when you subtract, when J is 1, for example, we are taking higher rotational number J equal to 1 and J dash equal to 0, then the frequency can be calculated by just substituting the values here. That is, just you h by 8 pi square, that is B, no, B in common, J into J plus 1, it is the lower quantum level. Here J dash into J dash plus 1, it is the higher rotational quantum level. So, the difference between these two. So, finally, it has reached, we have got this final equation, B into J plus 1 minus J dash into, just you are getting the difference, that's all. Okay, so by substituting, we are getting one case, that is one example, J higher rotational number value 1 and lower rotational value it is equal to 0. When you substitute, it becomes 2B centimeter inverse. Okay, when it is from 0 to 1. When it is from 0 to 2, that is 0 rotational level to second rotational energy level. So, you have to substitute the J value to be 2, higher value, and lower it is to be it is 1. That is okay. It is sorry, here J value it is not correctly given. It is 1. Okay. So, higher value is equal to 2 and lower value J dash value is equal to 1. When you substitute, you can get the value, that is 4B. So, listen girls, here what I am coming to say is, see, 0 to 1, when there is the transition 0 to 1 and from 0 to 1, 0 to 2 and 0 3, whatever transitions, these transitions are separated by the distance 2B. That's all I want to convey, right? So, first one, 0 to first energy level, 0 to first energy level means, 0 to first energy level means I got 2B value. Okay. The next one is 0 to 2 energy level. There, the transition, there I got 4B. Okay. Then, what is the difference between those two? That is 4B minus 2B, it is equal to 2B. Like that, when we go for 0 to 3, that transition, it will come to 6B. So, third and second, when we take 6B minus 4B, it is 2B. So, always remember, the rotational lines are recorded in a particular distance. That is, when we get the rotational spectra, the lines will be recorded with a very perfect correct distance between them. That distance we can call as a constant distance. This is because of this 2B difference. Okay, like that it may be asked, a question may be asked, prove that or justify that rotational, that is consecutive rotational lines in the rotational spectra is obtained in a constant distance. How can you justify like that? They will ask. So you have to write this answer. Okay. So this is about rotational energy. The theory part of rotational spectroscopy is this. Just for a diatomic model type, that is rigid rotor model type, what is the energy and what happens when you substitute the J values in energy, and what is the difference? That is, when you go for one transition, you have to get the difference. That is energy difference. Okay. So higher always, higher energy level to lower energy level. And one you have to consider that I have here it is represented that the zero level, the transition from zero to first energy level and zero to second energy level, zero to three, zero to four, zero to five, like that it is represented. But there is one selection rule, that is all the transitions are not permitted. Okay, always spectra is having some selection rule. All transitions are not possible or not permitted. Only some transitions will occur. Accordingly, we can say that for rotational spectroscopy, the selection rule is delta J equal to plus or minus 1. That is, when it is absorption spectroscopy, either it will move only one step ahead, or it in the emission spectra, it will come one step down. That's all. Okay. So the transition, it is possible only from, if at all, if the atom is, that is electron is in zero state, it will move to the transition will be only to one, state one, rotational energy level one. If it is in one, then it will go to only two. The transition between 1 and 2 and 1 and 3, they are forbidden. They cannot occur. So, J equal to, that is rotational energy level, J 0 to J equal to 2. Like that, they are all not possible at all. So, we used to call this as selection rule. Like a rule, the transition will occur only, yes, to only one step ahead it will go. That is only one energy level, plus or minus one only. So if it is absorption spectroscopy, it will move from lower to higher. Okay, higher means that is the immediate next level. If it is emission spectra means it will come immediately down, immediate down level only. Okay, so this is the selection rule of rotational spectra.